Evil Labs. Round 2. I actually played for a while in one file, but it seemed to got corrupt, I don't know. So I decided to play again. This is the second save file, but it still works. And here we go, there's a center. I'd say I'm pretty much late game at this point. Funny thing, I still didn't build a marketing department. But, you know, you don't really need one. But, there. Built. And I can't do campaigns unless I research them, which is here. 3,000 research points. I'd like to think I'm successful. It's interesting because I actually have done this legitimately, as in my evil lab has not created a single disease yet. We have just been selling regular pharmaceuticals to the populace en masse. So, what does that mean? It means that it's time probably to start a disease, I think. I set my prices accordingly. Great, I have to yawn. It's Christmas. It's not Christmas Eve yet. Christmas Eve is tomorrow. But you really need only one bed for three people, to be honest. So I have 18 beds, so that would be good for 36 people. I have, I think, enough scientists to fill all this up, but not everything is upgraded fully yet. That's the thing. Where is it? Yeah, these four things need attention, but don't have them yet. But here's the bread and butter of the game, supposedly. And I was waiting on to get last disease dispersion, and then maybe viruses, but I think I have enough to actually create a pretty darn good disease. So let's develop a disease. Protozoa, spores, bacteria. Let's do bacteria. Actually, I want to skip over to here right now and say hard to cure, really high dispersion, really strong potency. And it's a bacteria. You need symptoms and how to spread it, that's the thing. If it's bacteria, I'd like to spread it through rats, oh my. Well, apparently we can't have all of this because there's just not enough disease points to go around. So, I guess either really strong diseases or dispersion. I guess I can take away that. Spread my bacteria through bedbugs. Rats. Spread them through sweat. Huh. Yeah, that's five disease points. Shit, man. Then I have no symptoms, though, so there are no symptoms. So if we do this instead, I guess we can just make it hard to cure, but its dispersion will be normal. What are its symptoms? Bacteria. Bacteria spread through sweat. That would be interesting. Affects the, oh, these are one. Bronchitis. Trembling. Blisters. Huh. Peeling. Muscle stiffness. Bellyache. Vomit. Gastrules. Highly painful burning feeling in the stomach. Cool. Maybe I'll do three and one. Blisters. And muscle pain. felt tingling and blisters, though that would annoy everybody. There. Now let's spread it. This is my very first disease, so... Let's do it. And it is a... 20 already got cured, so I only get 21 new people to buy my shit. Well, that sucks. Well, 21 people is 21 people, and, oh, I forgot I can, jack that shit up to 60 with these 20 people. You're sick, dude. You'd better buy my cures. Oh, you fuckface. You just lost sales because... Too expensive, huh? Alright, I guess I'm getting greedy. Let's go back to 50. Alright. See, they should finish the person they're on, even if you're below your auto do whatever. You know? I think that's everybody who's sick. Nope, there's still someone sick there. She's still willing to pay 50. Cool. Alright. Well, it said there were 21 people needing the cure, but if it's still being sick, will it still get transferred past the initial? You know? I think so. Now, this is how we make all of the money. Go down to the metro. Yep, you're sick too. You're sick too. Everyone's willing to spend 50 bucks on cures. Make everybody sick. Yeah. I have the cure. You have the money. I see how we could both benefit from this. You don't have a sickness. If the next person walking through doesn't have a sickness, I better jack down the price again. Yeah. Looks like it's spread its course. Back down to 30. 30's too expensive for you, huh? You're still sick. Come back here, no eyes.
I don't have the money.
Well, that's your fault. Get richer. Quicker. Just do it now. Make me happy. Well, I went through some of my inventory. A shelf's worth. That's fine. Still got some research points coming. That's pretty good. Nobody's working. Nobody's selling shit. Where are you going? I have you guys at different levels for a reason, so that there'd always be somebody here. But I guess not. I guess this isn't how it works. I made a little bit of pocket change on that one. So I'd like to research some of this expensive stuff, but I don't care about any of that. What I do care about is... Well, this would be nice. Marketing, I suppose. There, I did marketing, but you can't do it again. But now that you've done marketing, you can do a campaign. Yeah. Let's see if this helps. Well, you're pissed.
This pharmacy doesn't have any hiring of people... The things.
Okay, maybe I should just, invest in making that more comfy for you. There you go. Because I can do that. When you have late game like this, and the whole idea then is to spread disease, then the game becomes kind of fun. Where you can, you have to balance it because you don't have enough disease points that he didn't put in the cloning lab and whatever the other lab is. So you can't get the maximum amount of disease points. Which is a bit upsetting, but okay, I better just make that the most comfortable thing in the world too. Everyone's working. That's fine. Marketing. You're just throw a campaign out there. Let them come. There you go. There's some people coming. Buy our pharmacies today. We ail what has you. Yeah. We ail what has you. The disease that has you by the balls, we are ailing you. We are the one who's causing your ailment. So we ail what has you. We also cures what ail you. Cures what ails you. We ail what has you. We cure what ails you. There's your slogan. Oh, come on, bitch. You have money. Dig deep into your pockets and get it. Or your crotch or wherever the fuck you put your wallet. You don't have a wallet. You got a purse. Well, I don't know. With this, all this fucking SJW gender fluid shit these days, who the fuck knows what you are? Your pronoun is zur, and you identify as a wolfkin, right? That's you. That's what you do. So I have to call you Zerwolfkin instead of female. Yeah, because that's a thing. Because, yeah, just whatever. Doesn't do shit. I have 2,000 research points. Can't do anything with them right now. I could do this with 3,000 research points, but this is the thing that will do all of the things, upgrade all of the things. Or just make the lab bigger. My lab currently doesn't need to be bigger because I can't actually expand anymore. There's no need to. If I would, then you go down and then you build more houses. Sleeping quarters. But as it stands, I have 24, so I would do 8 more staff members total, so 32. So I would 32, 18. 18 is under 3 per rec, so that actually does work for this game. Because 3 per does work. Actually, you should spend 500 per room, up to 4,500, and make all of these rooms with the paintings. That would just, they would spend less time sleeping. Because I want you to do stuff. I don't want you to spend your life sleeping, because we have to sell shit. Buy my $2 candies. Who would put 8 quarters into one of these machines just to get some of that shit? I wouldn't. Anyway. Well, this is the game, ladies and gentlemen. Maybe I should, ail what has them again. Well, I guess we could. We have a ready disease. We did that, and it was caused by sweat. Saliva. Drop that a bit. Cure chance down a little bit lower. So, yeah. Just, kiss. And that's 5 disease points. That's only 3. Well, if it's going to be that, then we could also spread it airborne virus, and it could also spread by, rats I like. Bedbugs, too. Don't sleep in someone's sick bed, that's for sure. Contaminate rivers, ponds, and lakes. Yeah, this is pretty nice. So 3 of those. And it's still going to be bacteria. Unicellular beings, they can live in any human system. If it's bacteria, I mean, if it's going to be by kissing or saliva, so I probably want this instead of that, because it's going to live inside people. Yeah. Even though bacteria in your mouth is pretty prevalent, that takes only 1 disease point, so that's 8 fucking disease points, wow. Well, anyway, now that I have more points, You can spread this disease through air, through kissing. Bats? Rats. I actually prefer mosquitoes myself. What are our symptoms? Well, it would be the same symptoms. If it's the same symptoms, if it's the same disease, that just means my disease has mutated, right? Hallucination, that's a pretty good one. Blisters are painful. But everyone wants to cure the shits, trust me. But then you won't be able to get out of your house to buy the cure. Tingling is just annoying. No one likes it. Oh, palpitations. That's a thing. Redness. Itchiness. Well, muscle spasms and the shits. So while you're taking a shit, while you're taking a shit, you think you're having a heart attack. That's a good one. I like that one. I guess I can do that. Potency. That might be how long it lives. That might be how easy it is to spread. And that's how hard it is to cure. And that's how much it'll kill you. Oh, there. Now, spread it. Let's go back to this area. Its alertness is still one. Because I've already spread a disease in it. Already cured. God damn it. Okay, well, anyway. Now that we have sick people, my medicine's going to be $50. You will pay or you will suffer. You have money, I have the cure. I see how we can benefit. Okay. I know I got the game on slow speed right now, but, this is the game. You just wait for more research points, and once you've researched everything, fine. I do know the most efficient layouts for engineering and labs. For engineering, it's one big. Actually, it's two big and one small for a row. Here, I can get more production if I do a big lab and a small lab. But I currently have so much stock, it doesn't matter. I create more than I sell, you know. For science labs, if all of them are fully upgraded, the most for your money is 4 small, 1 big. For advanced labs in these. So you can get 50% and then 45%. See? 20%, 35, 45. So it's 45% or it's 50%. And I think I would rather have, well, 3 people at 45% than 2 people at 4 people at 45%, which would be 180%. As opposed to, I'd have to get rid of all 3 of these to get 145%. Yeah. So a big lab here doesn't make any sense. An advanced lab only makes sense if you have a full row of labs, even though only one scientist can work in these big labs. That's just the way it is. I was gonna upgrade the sleeping quarters so that people wouldn't spend a whole lot of time sleeping. Yeah. No, I don't want to click on you. I want to make your room more homey. Oh, you didn't get to buy my cures because you had no money. Well, fuck off. Yeah. Yeah. There you go. I like making all of the money. Need $500 each room. My labs could use an upgrade too to get faster research. But they also might buy candies or something, but who knows. These people aren't interested in eating. They're interested in not feeling like shit. So I get that. Yeah. Now I'm finally going through my back stock of medicine, which is nice. Money is useful for upgrading the rooms, but then once all your rooms are upgraded, you don't need it except to build new rooms. And then you'll be at saturation, so then, you know. People are still sick, with 20 people needing the cure. I know. Not sure why I'm not talking right now, but I was thinking of something. There. If you demolish the room, you get half the cost back of the room, but you get none of the you don't get any of the money back from the upgrades you gave it. So you don't get half back from the upgrades as well. So that's a little bit annoying. What's also annoying is you can't put a room's bulkhead directly up against the bulkhead of the building facility itself. Let me show you what I mean. Ow. That's loud. That is a loud, loud fucking clicky. Ow. Ow. Okay, nobody wants to buy my expensive medicine these days, so let's drop it back down to 30. And there you go. Go in there and browse, man. You don't gotta stand outside by the magazine rack. You can do your other stuff. What was I doing? Oh, yeah. I was gonna show you. See, you can share bulkheads on rooms like this. But you can't share that bulkhead with the wall. It doesn't let you do that. That's a bit annoying. So, we have all of the research points. 5,000, almost 6,000. These labs need to be upgraded. That's going to cost 900 per small lab to upgrade them. I'd rather upgrade the beds first so that they spend less time sleeping and more time working. Because that's just what you do. And with 6,000 research points, I can research fucking all. You know, that's 8,000. And that's 8,000. That's 7,500. And that's 9,000. Viruses are 10,000. This would be the next thing on the list if you're going from cheapest to most expensive. And you might say, Zen, you've got this right here. Lethality. Yeah, but I don't want people to die. I want them to be sick. I want them to be sick and get cured. If they're dead, they won't buy my shit because they're dead. That's just a thing. Although I don't know if dead bodies spread them faster. Who knows? I seem to be making no money right now. Anyway. The most efficient use of power is one big station and four small stations as well. Again, engineering labs to actually create your medicine is too big and one small. Even with the extra space you can't use, it's too big and one small. Bigger are always better for that. Labs, not so much. Power, not so much. The reason I have them situated the way I do is as follows. Staff do not walk through the science closet, the tools cabinet, or the project room. They're just there to do stuff. Since no staff visits them, they don't waste time walking into them. So you don't want them to waste time walking through them to other rooms, so you want to put them as far away from the traffic as possible. No staff ever needs to visit human resources, marketing, or administration. It's just odd because there are two seats here. You think that in the future he might upgrade it to where people will visit human resources once in a while. They'll have another need. But as of right now, nobody walks through it, so you can put it as far back as possible to avoid having people having to walk through that room to get to a useful room. People only walk to the clinic if they're low on health, and they only get low on health if they have nothing to eat and they're hungry. Like, they can't get food when they're down, like, to 0% belly. That's the only way you lose health. You don't lose health by working fatigue or anything else, which is weird. You should lose health that way, too. But as it stands, because this is an alpha/beta, you only lose health by not eating. It seems even with 24 people, 4 seats in the mess hall is all you need right now. They'll just wait to get fed when it's necessary. You don't seem to need another dining hall. Although, if I expanded this further down, I would actually put another dining hall. And I would build more seats. Just to make it more suitable for my own tastes. I'm not sure if I would put it here with these two power generators. Probably not, because I want to make the power room as efficient as possible. So I would probably put it here. And then put, for aesthetic purposes, I could put another one, another whole line of this crap. But you can only go so far with the billion expansions. There's only 9, 10 levels total. So I'm up to 6. I'd only be able to expand 4 more levels. Which is just enough to mirror this, to have 18 rooms, so that's it, that's the game. I won't be playing this game anymore for YouTube, because currently there's nothing else in it. Just like all the other alpha games I've played, or beta games, there's no more content, other than what I've just shown you. I could make them go faster, but that's about it. What was I doing with the 7,000 research points? I was going to disease, and I was going to research this at 7,500. Okay. Oh, wait. I was actually going to show you the miscellaneous. Yeah, right here. 6, 7, 8, 9. So 4 more levels. You can research up to 9 additional levels, which means 10 sub-levels. This is 8,000, though. I don't need it. Because currently you can't build the other two labs, so you might as well just fill the space out with small labs and get as much research as you can. And as much power as this will allow you, and that'll be as much power as you need. And this is currently all the production you need until you sell your stock by making diseases, then you need to pump up your game. But if you're not making diseases, you don't need to step up your game, because these guys will keep pace, if you will. Although I haven't upgraded them, it would probably be nice to actually promote you. And where's the other one? Where's the other one? He's somewhere. He's sleeping. Mm-hmm. Well, if I just promote you, then you don't have to sleep anymore. Then when you promote them, they don't remember where they were, and you gotta reassign them. Don't promote people when they're working at their station, because it tends to bug out the station, and then you can't delete the station currently. That happened to me with my living room that I had in this corner up here. I couldn't delete it. It always kept saying in use. Maybe promoting people in this bedroom means I can't delete it either, because it still says it's in use, but I don't intend to change the location of these bedrooms. I do have $1,000. I could upgrade the labs. But again, I was upgrading the sleeping quarters with all of the money. And almost done. Well, okay, then I guess it's time to quit the recording and say, well, your entire lab will fit on this one screen until you upgrade the expansions left and right, which I don't see a need to do right now. It's too expensive in research, and there's not much to get out of it. Plus, you also can't build upward, and I really would like to put things up in this building. Sleeping quarters up here so that staff have higher morale. Marketing, administrative, and admin and human resources should be in this building too. And this building should be able to support 3 big buildings side by side. And if you ask me, this area should support 3 big buildings side by side, and it can't because it's one short. Which pisses me off a lot. Okay, well, that's it. I will save. That's this game for you. And you better save, because this game does not auto-save. Yeah, keep that in mind. This game does not auto-save. Okay, see you later.